My dear Mrs. Posvar, I am excited to be chatting with you today. How are you?
I'm fine. You called me. So you are so formal.
Well, it's the tuxedo. You know, I kind of have to get a go with that. What do you prefer?
Well, I would have worn an evening gown had I known that you were going to be in a tuxedo.
But you have had quite a career as an opera singer, not just you locally, all over the world. You were a featured performer for, I believe, 23 consecutive seasons at the Met.
You've done your homework
Well, it's impressive.
My goodness gracious.
And I think that even in the opera community, I mean, that's considered to be pretty impressive, yeah?
Well, I have to explain. In my era, which was the Rudolph Bing era, when he hired somebody, he hired them not just for one or two performances. He hired them, especially we American singers. He respected us so much. And he hired us, and he hired us for longevity and for growth. And I went from medium roles to big roles. Mm-hmm. And however, I don't seem to see that right now at the Met. I'm a little discouraged because I know of several singers who have finally gotten a Met contract. But what for? For a couple of evenings, couple of parts, and then that's over. And that's not the way I would run the opera company.
Well,
and
you
thanks God I'm not running that opera company.
But you yourself have done a lot to promote opera and opera singers here in this city. But in 1978, you founded Opera Theater Pittsburgh,
yeah.
And I believe we're in a sense running that for a while.
My case is, how shall I start? My reason for starting the company was that I was very, very fortunate to be part of a fledgling opera company in Boston when I was a graduate student there. It was called the New England Opera Theater, and that's where my name comes from, absolutely. New England Opera Theater, and it was founded by Boris Goldovsky. And he was my mentor, and so under him I sang Carmen, Cherubino 25 times, Hänsel and Idomeneo and several other roles, so that when I got to Germany, I could say I have sung these roles. And it was a young professional company, and I could say I had sung it professionally. So they took me seriously and let me audition. When I did sing in Germany, I realized how many opera companies there were all over the place, just for the Germans. And here I come from this United States of America, where I say we're the most talented nation in the world because we're all mixed up.
Yeah,
you
we
know?
Sure are.
We've got a little bit of Italian, a little bit of German, French, Irish, everything, and we're the best. I saw that they had this opportunity, and I was having this opportunity in Germany, and was hired after 1 year by Rudolph Bing, after 1 year in Germany, because I had European experience.
Mm-hmm.
So when my career started wending, I came here to Pittsburgh. One of the boards I was asked to be on was the Gateway to Music.
Mm-hmm.
It was called then. And they said to me, the schools want opera, and would I oversee it? And that first year, we had 90 performances in the schools.
Wow.
And I got involved with their development, with doing it 90 performances. And I said, oh, they deserve to do it the right way. But anyway, I got hooked. And so finally I found myself with an opera company.
Now, is it true that you sang at the White House?
Mm-hmm.
How was that? And what president was it that loved opera so much?
Nixon.
And there's also another event here in Pittsburgh that carries your name, that really helps give blossoming opera singers a big career boost, and that is the Mildred Miller International Voice Competition.
We had over 220 contestants.
And from all around the world.
From all around the world.
Come here to Pittsburgh.
Yes.
And the finals are open to the public. We can come and see them.
Oh, perform. Yes.
So it's kind of like American Idol a little bit. Except classier.
Except classier.
And what is the prize? What is everybody after when they compete in this?
$5,000 and a leading role at the Summer Festival here in Pittsburgh next summer.
Pretty good. And bragging rights, of course. I mean, that's a nice star to put on your resume.
Yes, absolutely.
Wow.
And our first three winners for the first 3 years.
Because this will be the fourth year. Right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Are just doing beautifully.
You have been a judge for this competition.
Yes, and I will be a judge again. Years.
So what do you look for in a contestant?
Una voce. The voice.
The it.
The it. Then we look at everything else.
Hmm. And I would...
And our last particular winner, Elizabeth Baldwin, she was that kind of winner in which she opened up her mouth and everybody would say, my God, there's an opera singer.
Wow.
My husband was a martini drinker and... I don't think I was a drinker of any kind at that point. And martinis got me married. I got...
How many did it take?
I think I was already happy on two. And I haven't drunk them since.
Oh, until today.
Until today.
Well, cheers. Welcome back.
Thank you. Thank you.
You founded Opera Theater Pittsburgh in
1979. Yes. 79? I thought it was 78.
Oh, let's fact check. 78. Our fact checker.
Yes.
You
yes,
are
yes.
on the ball. I did that just to check it out. I wanted to make sure you were legitimate there.
My daddy had 9 fingers, actually 9.5 fingers, and he played the piano by ear.
To make up for that extra finger?
Yeah. In the 16th, 17th centuries, little boys who had wonderful soprano roles were castrated so that their beautiful soprano voices would stay with them as adults. Oh. Isn't that horrible?
I think I need a drink.
I was used to performing and everything was arranged. I had no idea that all those people were working so hard to make it possible for me to get up and make a damn fool of myself. They asked me to be on this board and that board. And by the way, I never knew that being on a board meant you had to go to meetings.
I think that's the first rule, yeah. Well, cheers.
I drank all of mine.
You look at that. Nobody's ever beat me before. Look at this.